Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ankit Jain from Lium Solar Energy Private Limited. Today I'll be talking about round the clock power. So round the clock power summarizes 24/7 power. So India is already the world's fourth largest producer and the user of energy, and now clearly on the track of moving rapidly from coal and fossil fuel to the renewable energy. By introduction of net metering facility, all the consumers, residential and the commercial customers are moving towards CAPEX projects and solarization of their roofs. Now it is accessible to all the customers to have these kind of projects, and they are getting benefits out of that. In just 5 years, we have seen a major shift of solar sector. Earlier, people were very much reluctant to adopt these kind of technologies. Now, after installation of one of the project in nearby areas, they realize the benefit. And now people are hungry. Now people look for renewable energy sources because this is giving them benefit. So government major initiatives like Power to All, that gives around the clock power. And now many states which were unelectrified from long time are getting electrification, and India is moving towards 100% household electrifications. So I'll just brief about our company profile, that what kind of solutions we are doing for round the clock power. So I'll take 3 case studies where we have given our clients the round the clock power. So one is the case of a commercial client, a specific case in which he was setting up a CAPEX plant in his textile unit, and he was also having a DG set. So we worked on a solution of synchronizing the DG set with renewable asset, and then we successfully implemented that project. So in the daytime, the energy is produced by solar power, and when there is a power cut, the power is produced and synchronized with the DG synchronization system. The second specific case, which we are working with Indian Oil from around 3 years, we are providing them hybrid solution with the retail outlet solarization projects. We have developed a solution for their petrol pumps to give power 24/7. In the daytime, they get power through solar panels. In the nighttime, they get power through batteries, storage. And batteries are getting charged through solar panels. So through that, they can achieve the round-the-clock power. And the third case is a very interesting project which we are doing in beach side of Padubidri and Udupi. That is a SICOM project funded by World Bank. And we are developing a battery storage system, a container-based battery storage system on the beaches of Padubidri and Udupi, where we are synchronizing the solar rooftop system with the batteries and giving them around-the-clock power with the autonomy of 3 days. So learning from 3 specific cases is the battery. So battery is the future for renewable energy and for round-the-clock power. And there is a lot of technology enhancement and lot of infrastructure enhancement is required in battery storage so that we can achieve the round-the-clock power. And for achieving round-the-clock power, batteries cost should come down. Whenever the battery's cost will come down, automatically India will move towards one step ahead for round-the-clock power. And even there are many rural areas and there are many far-off places where they look for these solutions which can give them around-the-clock power. Give them a brief about the company. We are in the space of distributed solar. We provide end-to-end solar solution to corporates, PSUs, government organizations, and residential clients. Our focus is always to provide affordable and clean source of energy to our clients. We provide end-to-end solutions starting from feasibility, paperwork, local licensing, assessment, installation, O&M. So, talking about our journey, it's been 4 years and we have 150 plus customers. which includes commercial clients, residential clients, and the PSU clients. Talking about our presence, it's pan-India presence, and our major of the clients present in Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. So, concluding this thing, I'll just talk about three things which need to be worked. Is first is technology enhancement that should be supplemented by concrete policy and regulatory provision that would provide a clear roadmap for implementing smart technologies. Secondly, initiatives for power outage management system, power quality management, demand response, and renewable energy integration. As Animesh rightly said, is like, DISCOMs should come out of stress zone, because if DISCOMs will be in the stress zone, automatically we will not able to get the 24/7 power, because the governing body is the DISCOMs. And secondly, the smart meters will be the game changer, because that will enhance them to come out of the stress-free zone. From that, the manpower cost will going to come down. Secondly, the they will be able to track the power, and they will be able to check out any power which is going out irregularly. And third is the EV storage system. So the whole world is talking about EVs, but automatically EV charging station will lead to a lot of power requirement. So what we are doing with EV charging stations, and from where that power will come? So we have to work on the technology where EV charging station should be adaptable with solar and storage, and automatically that whole system works, off the grid, without the grid. So that will be the, ideal case scenario for future, where the EV charging station is working from solar and battery storage and charging stations. So this kind of enhancement will lead to around the clock power. Thank you so much.